Curtain wall system families, by default, they're very basic in Revit. What happens if you want to get glass spacers, extra mullions, more details, hardware, and much more content? And in this video, we are going to cover how to get those in Revit. The curtain wall system families has an LDAF of limitation in Revit. So depending on your scope and what you really want to achieve, you need to decide whether you would like to stick with those or you want to create in-place systematic parametric Revit families. So I will be explaining you both the differences, where the limitations are, but at the same time, you need to define and understand the three main content that we will be sharing in this video, like the level of development you would like to achieve. So is it for shop? Is it for a bill of materials? Is it for assembly? What is the purpose? Is it for visualization? You need to answer that question and define the real level of development needed or level of information needed, you can say, because it's really important so you don't over detail or over model your project. The second point is to define a logic, because when you change the parameters of the overall component, we'd like to understand how it behaves, especially if it's an in-place Revit family. And the third one is to create a light components. So those are so light that when you assemble together, it doesn't overkill your Revit model, because we have seen Revit models that are over 500 megabytes, over 800 megabytes, and that's overkill. Please comment below if you have been struggling with filters in Revit or any other schedules in Revit, so we will be able to answer those questions for you. So let's jump into it. So we will be discussing curtain walls with system families, and we will be discussing curtain walls with in-place families. They contain different level of developments, and there are different drawbacks for both. So let's go to the floor plan in order to see what we have here. On the right-hand side, in the in-place family, we have loads of details. So we can see the key stokes, we can see the trims, glass spacers, there are loads of information. And on the left side, the actual system families, the curtain wall system families, have a bit of limitation to there. So we can have few things. We can have the end portion over here, end detail. We can make sure that the glass goes inside it. We can place different kind of seals in between. So in this case, there is a 10 millimeter connector, but we can have also 12 millimeter connector, and there are corner connectors. So depending on the solution that we are looking for. So when we compare directly, we need to understand first thing, the level of development, level of information needed. Where do you want to really go? Do you want to get all this information, or do you want to just stay with the basic information? Perhaps if you go with the in-place families, there are some drawbacks I will be explaining shortly. But before I explain that, I would like to show you what you can get with the curtain walls that are in-place families. You can have all those details. And if you want to split, then make a drawing package for the shop, for the bill of materials, you'll be able to get all those data directly from the drawings. That's really awesome, right? So it contains a lot of information, and you can get all those details right away. So if I go to the next sheet, these are the connectors. It shows the angle cuts. I can go to the glazing portions, how the bill of material is extracted for the glazing portions, and I can go scroll down and see how the glass spacers are laid out, the length and everything about, and how you can assembly and construct it. So it contains a lot of data. But in the system families, unfortunately, you cannot get that much data. So we are a little bit limited with the options, because even for the glazing, you can see that we were overlapping it a bit. So in order to get the overlap for the glazing, because it was very difficult and it's impossible to extend the glass on both sides when you add details. So when you add mullion, you cannot really add the extension on both sides. So where the glass ends, that's where it starts. So it's a bit of a difficult thing to manage, because that's how the curtain wall system families are made. So therefore, you need to really pay attention what you really need and how I would like to achieve those. So you can see that if I extend this portion over here, we can get connectors, seals in the middle. Yes, it's expanding, that's correct. However, one thing to keep in mind that we have a little control about that. So we cannot really have a lot of things. We cannot add glass spacers on the sides. We cannot have too many things. We can only add a splice in between, and it can count as one object, but that's again, very limited approach. When we go with the actual in-place family, you can use it. I will have to click a couple of times tab, and then you can use it in a different format. So if I extend this portion over here, I can extend the wall again, similar to the system families. However, this contains a lot more information. It's really convenient to use. You can also go ahead and use the actual parameters. There are loads of dimensions, loads of information. And here we can see in the in-place families that we can have a lot of information. We can get any information we can set lots of constraints, and contain other formulas, and we can really control what we would like to get out of that. So if you want to move the connector to height, or connector tree height, which is this connector two is this one, connector three is that one. So I can just demonstrate to you, so you can see visually how it works. So if I do 1.8 meters, it will push the connector tree down. I can just push this one down to 500. It will move it down, and I can move the central middle post from like about 2 meters. So I can have a great control around my curtain wall. And I will contain all these details, and if I tag them in the drawing package, everything will be consistent, and everything, if I change something, everything will be there, nothing will be removed. So that's a really great advantage. Coming back to the second thing is that you need to define a logic. Once you decide what level of information you are going for, what level of development you are going for, so you need to define level of information needed. Once you define that, if you're going that level of detail, or if you are going this level of detail, you need to define a logic. How we are going to sustain it, how we are going to make it parametric in a way that it will be working consistently. So right now we have lots of formulas to get all the lengths we want, all the other items we want, all the offsets we want. So we have a great control over this family. And we only have a couple of constraints that we are measuring and playing with. It's giving us all the results. So you need to go that way, or you need to go another approach. You need to decide on a logic and how we are going to make it. If I open this family, you will see there are loads and loads of constraints. And if I go inside here, you will see loads and loads of formulas. So there are really a lot of things we are involving. Lots of formulas are involved, and we need to build a logic so it can be used again and again in every single project. The third thing you need to focus is you need to make that family light. If you make this family heavy, you will not be able to play with it. Because imagine that you have lots of families placed in your project, and if it's really heavy, look how fast it is. If I change the parameter, it really applies it very quickly. So if it takes ages, or if it slows down the project, that's a huge problem for you, because we have even mobile structures, we can just click button and it shifts. For is it like a sliding portion, sliding curtain wall, or is it like a fixed curtain wall? Is there a truck underneath or not? So we have lots of options, but we are trying to make as light as possible. So some kind of like ideas that I could say is that when you create a void inside a solid, or multiple voids inside a solid, try to make the solid without using any voids, if in the first case, if that's possible. So that will save you a lot of megabytes, trust me. You saw what's capable in Revit, so you can create a really good level of detail curtain walls that will be really beneficial for you. You can just stretch and play, but you need to set the logic in the set level of development straightforward, and then you can get all the quantities you need. So if I go to the panel schedule, I will be able to get the panel schedule of my curtain walls and how many glasses I have, all the if it's taped or not. So lots of information. But we build the logic, we build the level of development, and we build it light, so it's fast and it's accurate. Please comment below if you have been working with curtain walls at this level of development, at this level of detail. Did you really go so much deeper into it? And did you know at all you can reach this level of development so fast? And it can be really fun to play with the curtain walls. So did you know about it? Please comment below. Don't forget to like and subscribe to our channel, because every week we are going to share a lot of BIM-related content and technology-related content with you. We will be doing BIM Talks, where we will be inviting a guest every 2 weeks, and we'll be asking questions that you are interested in to them, so you can learn more out of the experienced industry professionals. You'll be able to get this experience only in the paid seminars or maybe nowhere else. So don't forget to hit the notification icon, you don't miss any of the great content.